Let's take a look at a quick exercise just to make sure the idea of a three-way join is crystal clear. We're going to try to solve a problem very, very similar to the one that we just went through in the last video. So we are again working with a table of authors and books, and now we've got a new table inside of here, a table of reviews. Reviews has a couple of columns inside of it. It's got an ID, of course, and then a rating. The rating is the rating of a book on a scale from 1 to 5. So a 5 would mean that a book was very good, and a rating of 1 would mean that maybe the book is not so great. There's then a reviewer ID inside of here. The reviewer ID column stores the author or the ID of the author who created the review. So this first review right here has a reviewer ID of 1. That means that the first review was created by Stephen King. The next review was created by an author with an ID of 2. That means the second one was created by Agatha Christie. And as you can guess, last one is J.K. Rowling. And then finally, the third column is the ID of the book that the review is for. So for example, the first review was a review for the book Affair at Styles. Okay, so we've got these three tables, and now here is our goal. We're going to return the title of each book, along with the name of the author and the rating of a review. But here's the critical part. We only want to show rows where the author of the book is also the author of the review. That is our join criteria right there. That is the critical part. So just to make sure that what we're doing here is very clear, let's walk through this in diagram format very quickly. So I'm going to again do a three-way join here because I want to get information from all three tables. If we did not need information from all three tables, we could potentially just do one join and then maybe use a where statement instead. We're going to first start off with our reviews as the from table. So we're going to take all the different reviews, and we, as usual, we can imagine that we put them into this very temporary table. We'll then join in books. And when we join this in, we're going to take a look at every one of our reviews. We're going to take a look at the book ID column and try to match it up, the value inside there, to one of the rows inside of books. So we've got a book ID of 2 that would match up with Affair at Styles. So we put that right there. We've got a book ID of 1. That would match up with the Dark Tower. And then finally, a book with ID 3. That would match up with Chamber of Secrets. Okay, so there is reviews and books. That's a normal join. We have gone through this process many times. Now here is the three-way join. We're now going to merge in authors. So with authors, here's the hard part, the part that we really got to think about for a little bit. We want to somehow use the following join criteria. We want to put in a value right here where the row out of the author's table has an ID equal to the reviewer ID, and that same author has an ID equal to that same row's author ID. So in other words, we want to do a comparison between reviewer ID and ID and author ID and ID. In this case, there is no author who has an ID of 1 and simultaneously an ID of 2. There's no author in this table who has an ID of 1 and 2 at the same time. It just doesn't exist. So we would end up with, right here, null and null. So then on the next one, we've got a reviewer ID of 2 and an author ID of 1. We need to find an author who has an ID of 2 and 1 at the same time. Well, once again, doesn't exist. So we would end up with null and null. And then finally, on the very last one right here, we want to find an author with an ID of 3 and an ID of 3. Well, in this case, yep, it does exist. It is J.K. Rowling. So J.K. Rowling would end up right there. So this would be our full join table. All three tables joined together. And then finally, we would probably want to do an inner join here. If we did an inner join, then any of these rows that ended up not being able to be matched up would be dropped out. So we would drop out 1 and 2 like so. And that would leave us with just J.K. Rowling, who, I guess, left a review for her own book. It's okay. They were good books anyhow. All right, so that's the idea. Go ahead and give this a shot. Again, the actual query you're going to write is going to look very similar to the one that we just wrote in the last video. So if you need any reference, you can always go back to the last video and just take a look at how that one was written. Go ahead and give this a shot, and I'll see you in just a minute.